85 GK questions and answers on Hyderabad history and culture. What is unique about Hyderabad? Hyderabad, known as the city of Nijams, it is an attractive tourist place. Hyderabad, located on the banks of River Musi, it is the largest city and the capital of the state of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Hyderabad is home to many traditional and ancient markets and the famous Hyderabad biryani. What is the traditional dress of Hyderabad? The traditional Hyderabadi garb is sherwani kurta pajama and lungi for men, saris, kara dupatta and salwar kameez for women. Burqa and hijab is commonly practiced among the Muslim women in public. Most of the youth wear western clothing. Who destroyed Golconda Fort? Emperor Aurangzeb. In 1686, the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb attacked the Golconda Fort with an intention to seize Hyderabad. The fortress was invulnerable and held out against Aurangzeb for 9 months before falling to the Mughals through treachery. Are Nizam's Mughals? Nizams were subordinate to Mughals. That is, they worked for Mughals but later carved an independent state of Hyderabad in 1724, which they ruled strong-handedly after the disintegration and weakening of Mughal power in the 18th century and had hereditary successors known as Nizams of Hyderabad. What was Hyderabad before? Andrew Peterson, a scholar of Islamic architecture, says the city was originally called Baghnagar, City of Gardens. One popular theory suggests that the founder of the city, Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah of the Golconda Sultanate, named it after Bagamati, a local notch dancing girl with whom he had fallen in love. What is the famous dance of Hyderabad? Kuchipudi. Kuchipudi is one of the most celebrated forms of dance in Hyderabad. The dance is a mixture of acting and poetic movements, accompanied by classical Carnatic music. The movements are scintillating and heavy on the feet. This dance originated after the reign of the Nizams. When did Nizam's rule end? September 1948. However, his rule ended in September 1948 when the Indian Army launched Operation Polo, led by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, then Minister of Home Affairs and Deputy Prime Minister of India. The state of Hyderabad was invaded and the Nizam was forced to step down. The seventh and last Nizam, Mir Usman Ali Khan family. Spouse, Ajamunnisa Begum, Iqbal Begum. Children, Ajam Jah, Majam Jah. Grandchildren, Mukarram Jah, Mufakkam Jah. Mir Usman Ali Khan's second son, Majam Jah, married Princess Niloufar, a princess of the Ottoman Empire. In total, the Nizam had 34 children, 18 sons and 16 daughters. Who was the last Nizam? Mir Usman Ali Khan. The six-day Operation Polo, popularly known as police action, that led to the merger of Hyderabad state, centered around one man, Mir Usman Ali Khan, the last Nizam of the Asaf Jahi dynasty, which ruled over Hyderabad for a little over 200 years. What happened to Usman Ali Khan's wealth? The Nizam is known to have remained as the richest man in South Asia until his death in 1967, but his fortunes fell to $1 billion by then, as more than 97% of his wealth, including jewelry belonging to his family, including his daughters and granddaughters, was taken away by the newly formed Indian government. Why did Nizam support the British? As Nizam ruler, Nizam Ali Khan has entered into a subsidiary alliance with the British. Accordingly, the Britishers would provide army to the Nizams to guard his territory with a condition that salary would be paid by the Nizam. Was Hyderabad under British rule? The state was ruled from 1724 to 1857 by the Nizam, who was initially a viceroy of the Mughal Empire in the Deccan. Hyderabad gradually became the first princely state to come under British paramountancy, signing a subsidiary alliance agreement. During British rule in 1901, the state had an average revenue of ₹417 lakh, making it the wealthiest princely state in India. How many rooms are there in Taj Falaknama Palace? 220 rooms. The palace has 220 rooms and 22 halls and a private wing for the hotel. The first phase of renovation preserves the inherent history of the palace with a magnificent 101 seat dining room and the original Nizam suite. Who built Taj Falaknama in Hyderabad? William Ward Marriott. An English architect, William Ward Marriott designed the palace. Sir Vicar's monogram Vivo is on the furniture, walls and ceiling of the palace. It is made completely with Italian marble with stained glass windows and covers an area of 10,11,500 square feet. Is Falaknama Palace open to public? Although Taj Falaknama Palace is one of the most important palaces to visit in Hyderabad, it is not open for general public. If interested in visiting, you can book a day tour, Nizam Palace tour, by Telangana Tourism. This palace was taken over by Taj Group and has been opened as five-star hotel in the year of 2010. What is Falaknama Palace famous for? Located about 5 kilometers from Charminar, the Falaknama Palace is well known for its architecture and for housing the largest Venetian chandeliers. The palace has 40 beautiful Venetian chandeliers, often referred to as the Mirror of the Sky. The Falaknama Palace is 2000 feet tall. Which fort is situated in Hyderabad? Golconda Fort. If you ever chance to visit Hyderabad, the capital of Andhra Pradesh, you can possibly miss out the 400-year-old majestic and imposing Golconda Fort situated on the western outskirts in the city. The fort was built by the Kakatiya dynasty in the 13th century. Why is Golconda Fort famous? Golconda is a fortified citadel and an early capital city of the Qutub Shahi dynasty 1512 to 1687 century, located in Hyderabad, Telangana, India. Because of the vicinity of diamond mines, especially Kollur mine, Golconda flourished as a trade center of large diamonds known as the Golconda diamonds. Golconda, an enormous for just 11 kilometers outside of Hyderabad, is a ruined city. Surrounded by 10 kilometers of walls, the fort was built in the year 1525. What is special about Golconda Fort? Golconda Fort was first built by the Kakatiya dynasty as part of their western defenses along the lines of the Kondapalli Fort. The city and the fortress are built on a granite hill that is 120 meters high and is surrounded by massive battlements. The fort was rebuilt and strengthened by Prataparudra of the Kakatiyas, who ruled Golconda, Abul Hasan Qutub Shah. The siege of Golconda occurred in January 1687 when Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb led his forces to besiege the Qutub Shahi dynasty at Golconda Fort, also known as the diamond capital of its time, and was home to the Kolluru mine. The ruler of Golconda was the well-entrenched Abul Hasan Qutub Shah, who destroyed Golconda Fort. Emperor Aurangzeb. In 1590, the Qutub Shahi rulers shifted their capital to Hyderabad. In 1686, the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb attacked the Golconda Fort with an intention to seize Hyderabad. The fortress was invulnerable and held out against Aurangzeb for 9 months before falling to the Mughals through treachery. Which fort is famous for its acoustic effects in Hyderabad? Golconda Fort. The fort is famous for its acoustic effect. The fort is famous for its acoustic effects, which was an effective security measure in those days. It is said that the sound of clapping of hands at Fateh Darwaza can be heard clearly at Bala Hisar, the highest point situated about 1 kilometer away in Golconda Fort. What is Taramati? Taramati Baradari is consisted of a music hall with 12 entrances. According to tales, Taramati and Premamati, the two dancers and courtesans of the Abdullah Qutub Shah, who was the seventh Sultan of Golconda, used to often perform dances on a rope that was tied between Sultan's balcony and their place. Who is the last king of Golconda Fort? Abul Hasan Qutub Shah. The siege of Golconda occurred in January 1687 when Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb led his forces to besiege the Qutub Shahi dynasty at Golconda Fort, also known as the diamond capital of its time, and was home to the Kulluru mine. The ruler of Golconda was the well-entrenched Abul Hasan Qutub Shah. Who built Golconda Fort? The Golconda Fort was erected in the year 1143 under the Kakatiya dynasty. However, it rose to prominence when it came under the rule of Qutub Shahi dynasty during the 16th century, that is, when Quli Qutub Shah declared his independence from the Bahmani Sultanate in 1518. Why was Golconda Fort built? Kakatiya dynasty built the Golconda Fort to defend the western part of their kingdom. The fort was built on top of a granite hill. After this, Musunuri dynasty took over the fort by defeating Tughlaq's army. Later, the fort was given to the rulers of Bahmani Sultanate by Musunuri Kapaya Nayaka. Who is the first king of Golconda? The siege of Golconda occurred in January 1687 when Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb led his forces to besiege the Quli Qutub Shah dynasty at Golconda. It was home to the Kulluru mine. The ruler of Golconda was the well-entrenched Abul Hasan Qutub Shah. Where is Golconda Fort situated? Golconda, also spelled Golconda or Golconda, historic fortress and ruined city lying 5 miles, that is 8 kilometers, west of Hyderabad in western Telangana state, southern India from 1518 to 1591. It was the capital of the Qutub Shahi kingdom, one of 5 Muslim sultanates of the Deccan. Why is Golconda Fort famous? Golconda is a fortified citadel and an early capital city of the Qutub Shahi dynasty, located in Hyderabad, Telangana, India. Because of the vicinity of diamond mines, especially Kulluru mine, Golconda flourished as a trade center of large diamonds known as the Golconda diamonds. Is Golconda Fort a monument? Golconda Fort, located about 11 kilometers from Hyderabad, the Golconda Fort is one of the most magnificent forts of India. This ruined fortress has a glorious history which dates back to the 12th century. It is believed that the construction of the fort began in 1143 during the reign of the Kakatiya dynasty. Where is Nizam family now? 10 of Nizam's sons and daughters were issueless. He had 104 grandchildren, some of whom have passed away. Family sources said about 400 family members of the Nizam clan, mostly 5th and 6th generation, are settled in Hyderabad, other parts of India and abroad. Where is the Nizam diamond? Currently, it is kept at the Reserve Bank of India vaults in Mumbai as part of the Nizam's jewelry exhibition in 2001 and 2007. The Jacob diamond was a major attraction at Salarjung Museum, Hyderabad. What happened to Nizam's wealth? How did the Nizam's wealth end up in London's account? In the days leading up to India's independence, the 7th Nizam of Hyderabad, Usman Ali Khan, refused to join the Indian Union. The money in the Imperial Bank of India was transferred to a Hyderabad government account in other banks. What is Golconda famous for? Golconda is renowned for the diamonds found on the southeast at Kulluru mine near Kulluru, Guntur district, Paritala and Atkuru in Krishna district and cut in the city during the Kakatiya reign. At that time, India had the only known diamond mines in the world. What is the Hyderabad old name? The name Hyderabad reportedly had its origins in an affair between Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah and a local Telugu courtesan named Bagmati. He named the city Bhagyanagar after her, and after she converted to Islam and took on the name of Haider Mahal, he named the city Hyderabad. Who ruled Hyderabad first? Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah. Hyderabad was founded on the river Musi 5 miles east of Golconda, the capital of the Qutub Shahi rulers in 1591-92 by Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah. The Qutub Shahi dynasty founded the Kingdom of Golconda, one of the 5 kingdoms that emerged after the breakup of the Bahmani Kingdom. Why Hyderabad is called Cyberabad? The first IT hub in India, Cyberabad, is the first locality that was developed for the IT sector in the country. HICC, Hyderabad International Convention Center. Cyberabad is home to India's largest and the most technologically advanced convention center. Why Hyderabad is called Dakkan? The Dakkan produced some of the greatest dynasties in Indian history, one of which was the Asaf Jahi dynasty, better known as the Nizam of Hyderabad. The Hyderabad state played such an important role in the Dakkan that today Hyderabad is vaguely referred as Dakkan. Which sweet is famous in Hyderabad? Also popular as the banana sweet in Hyderabad, Mauz Ka Meetha is a famous sweet dish you can find in almost every corner of the city. It is prepared with banana, milk, ghee, sugar and nuts. What language is spoken in Hyderabad? Telugu. The official language of Hyderabad is Telugu, but there are various other regional languages spoken by the people of the state of Telangana. English is used for official and commercial purposes. What is the main food of Hyderabad? Hyderabadi biryani is one of the most popular dishes of the city. It is distinctly different from other variations of the biryani, originating from the kitchens of the Nizams of Hyderabad. It is a celebration dish of basmati rice and mutton along with yogurt, onions and various spices. What Hyderabad is famous for? Charminar. Hyderabad is the capital and largest city of the South Indian state of Telangana. It was ruled by the Qutub Shahis, Mughals and the Nizams, which shaped its history. The city is noted for its monuments, which includes the masterpiece of Charminar and the fort of Golconda. Which city is known as City of Pearls? That's Hyderabad. Hyderabad is considered the main pearl trading center in India, because of which the city is also known as the City of Pearls. What is famous for shopping in Hyderabad? Best places to shop in Hyderabad. Jumarat Bazaar. Shop for antiques at Jumarat. Lord Bazaar. Bangles are popular product at Lord Bazaar. Saharan Market. The Saharan Market is popular for clothes. Abbots Street. Perfume Market. Begum Bazaar. Mujan Jahi Market, Nampally Market. Are Hyderabad pearls real? Most traditional Hyderabad jewelry is made from white pearls. Pink and black pearls are high quality pearls and are considered rare and valuable. But today, all the processing is done by the pearl farm owners in China, Hong Kong, Australia, Japan, wherever the pearls are produced. Which season is best in Hyderabad? The best time to visit Hyderabad is between the months of November and February, which are the winter months, and the weather is cool and pleasant. Temperatures is usually hover between 14 degrees Celsius to 29 degrees Celsius during this time, and the weather is cool and dry. What can I buy from Hyderabad? Following are a list of things you could take from Hyderabad to gift your loved ones. Pearls. Hyderabad is known as the City of Pearls. Karachi Bakery for biscuits. Almond House. Lebanon Fine Baking. Hyderabadi Biryani. Clothing, accessories from old cities and sharees. Who developed Hyderabad city? In 1589, Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah, the fifth ruler of the Qutub Shahi dynasty, selected the present site of the city and established the city of Hyderabad at the banks of the Musi River to overcome water shortages and experienced at Golconda. How many years old is Hyderabad? Hyderabad and Secunderabad are twin cities separated by the Hussain Sagar, a man-made lake made during the time of Ibrahim Qutub Shah in 1562, ruled by the Qutub Shahis, the city has a history of nearly 400 years. What is the dance form of Telangana? Perini Shivatandavam or Perini Tandavam is an ancient dance from Telangana which has been revived in recent times. It originated and prospered in Telangana during the Kakatiya dynasty. The Perini Tandavam is a dance form usually performed by males. It is called Dance of Warriors. Why is Telangana famous? The cultural hearts of Telangana, Hyderabad and Warangal are noted for their wealth and renowned historical structures, Charminar, Qutub Shahi tombs, Paiga tombs, Falaknama Palace, Chohamalla Palace, Warangal Fort, Kakatiya Kalatornam, Thousand Pillars Temple and the Bonagiri Fort in Yadadri Bonagiri district. Which Indian city is famous for pearls? Hyderabad. The most notable area devoted to the trade is the village called Chandanapeta, just outside Hyderabad, wherein almost the entire population is engaged in the delicate art of drilling pearls, a skill they have practiced for generations. This practice also makes the city one of the largest pearl drilling locations in India. How did the Nizam become so rich? During the period of Nizam's rule, Hyderabad became extremely wealthy thanks to the Golconda mines, which were the only sources of diamonds in the world market at that time, apart from South African mines, making the 7th Nizam the richest person in the world. Can we climb Charminar in Hyderabad? Its name is derived from two words, Char and Minar, meaning four minarets. This historical landmark stands high in the sky, and every minaret has four stories with a carved ring. There are 149 steps inside the minaret that vacationers can climb in order to get a spectacular view of Hyderabad. Where did the Nizam come from? Asaf Jah, 7th, chose his grandson Nawab Mir Barakat Ali Khan Bahadur Mukarran Jah as his successor, but he was Nizam only in name, hailing from the region around Samarkand in modern-day Uzbekistan, the Asafzahi, who originally a Turkic dynasty. How did Hyderabad get its name? One popular theory suggests that the founder of the city, Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah of the Golconda Sultanate, named it after Bagmati, a local Nach girl with whom he had fallen in love. She converted to Islam and adopted the title Hyder Mahal. The city was named as Hyderabad in her honor. Which city is known as high-tech city? It's Hyderabad. The Hyderabad Information Technology and Engineering Consultancy City, abbreviated as high-tech city. It is an Indian information technology, engineering, health informatics and bioinformatics financial business district located in Hyderabad, Telangana state. Who ruled Hyderabad first? Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah. Hyderabad was founded on the river Musi, 5 miles east of Golconda, the capital of the Qutub Shahi rulers in 1591-92 by Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah. The Qutub Shahi dynasty founded the Kingdom of Golconda, one of the 5 kingdoms that emerged after the breakup of the Bahmani Kingdom. Why did Hyderabad join India? However, by 1948, almost all had acceded to either India or Pakistan. However, with the rise of the militant Rajakars, India found it necessary to station Indian troops and invaded the state in September 1948 to compel the Nizam. Subsequently, the Nizam signed an instrument of accession joining India. Why did India invade Hyderabad? According to an Indian government pamphlet, the communists had killed about 2,000 people by 1948. Major population of Hyderabad wanted to join India, but Nizam, with the help of Rajakars, tried to crush majority population, killed them, looted them, and wanted to remain independent to hold his power. Who ruled Golconda? Abul Hasan Qutub Shah. The siege of Golconda occurred in January 1687 when Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb led his forces to besiege the Qutub Shahi dynasty at Golconda Fort. It is also known as the diamond capital of its time and was home to the Kolluru mine. The ruler of Golconda was the well-entrenched Abul Hasan Qutub Shah. Why Hyderabad is called Dakkan? It was broadly referred to as Dakshin or Dakkan by the rest of the world. The Dakkan produced some of the greatest dynasties in Indian history, one of which was the Asaf Jahi dynasty, better known as the Nizam of Hyderabad. The Hyderabad state played such an important role in the Dakkan that today Hyderabad is vaguely referred to as Dakkan. How was Hyderabad formed in 1591? Hyderabad was founded on the river Musi, 5 miles east of Golconda, the capital of the Qutub Shahi rulers in 1591-92 by Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah. The Qutub Shahi dynasty founded the Kingdom of Golconda, one of the 5 kingdoms that emerged after the breakup of the Bahmani Kingdom. What is the importance of Hyderabad? Hyderabad has been an important city presently and historically. The city with its distinct Dakkani culture played a vital role in shaping the destiny of the city. Founded by Quli Qutub Shah, it was one of the wealthiest cities of that time. It was a trading hub for the pearl and diamond industry. Why did Hyderabad join India? Operation Polo was the code name of the Hyderabad police action in September 1948 by the then newly independent Dominion of India against the Hyderabad state. It was a military operation in which the Indian armed forces invaded the Nizam ruled princely state, annexing into the Indian Union. Did Nizam want to join Pakistan? On 11th June 1947, the Nizam issued a declaration to the effect that he had decided not to participate in the Constituent Assembly of the either Pakistan or India. However, the Nizams were Muslim ruling over a predominantly Hindu population. India insisted that the great majority of residents wanted to join India. The pressure grew and the Nizam finally chose to accede to Pakistan. Why is Nizam so rich? Mir Usman Ali Khan, the last Nizam of Hyderabad, became so rich due to a number of factors. One, first and foremost, the mining royalties given out and stone unearthed from the Golconda mine. Keep in mind that until 1900, Golconda in India was the only place in the world where diamonds were mined. How much did Nizam donate to India? According to an urban legend, Nizam Mir Usman Ali Khan donated 5,000 kg of gold to the National Defense Fund of India in the aftermath of the Indo-Pakistani War of 1965. How did Nizam of Hyderabad become independent? The first Nizam ruled in place of the Mughal emperors. After Aurangzeb died, the Mughal Empire collapsed. So the Nizams created an independent kingdom, that is Hyderabad. When the British got power over India, the Nizams continued to rule Kingdom of Hyderabad after coming into an understanding with the British. Who declared Hyderabad state as independent state on 13th August 1947? Usman Ali Khan Asaf Jah 7th. On August 13, 1947, then Sardar Patel requested Usman Ali Khan Asaf Jah 7th, the last Nizam of the princely state of Hyderabad, to join India, but the Nizam opposed it and instead declared Hyderabad as an independent state on August 15, 1947. How many years did Nizams ruled Hyderabad? It is 224 years. 7 Nizams ruled Hyderabad for 2 centuries until Indian independence in 1947. The Nizams ruled the state until September 1948 after independence from the British. The Nizams that ruled the erstwhile princely state of Hyderabad for average 224 years. What happened to Usman Ali Khan wealth? The Nizam is known to have remained as the richest man in South India until his death in 1967, but his fortune fell to $1 billion by then, as more than 97% of his wealth, including jewelry belonging to his family, including his daughters and granddaughters, was taken away by the newly formed Indian government. Was Nizam of Hyderabad richest man in the world? During his days as Nizam, he was reputed to be the richest man in the world, having a fortune estimated at $2 billion in the early 1940s, $36.5 billion today, or 2% of the US economy then. Where are the descendants of Nizam of Hyderabad? 10 of Nizam's sons and daughters were issueless. He had 104 grandchildren, some of whom have passed away. Family sources said about 400 family members of the Nizam clan, mostly 5th and 6th generation, are settled in Hyderabad, other parts of India and abroad. What is Falaknama Palace famous for? Located about 5 kilometers from Charminar, the Falaknama Palace is well known for its architecture and for housing the largest Venetian chandeliers. The palace has 40 beautiful Venetian chandeliers, often referred to as the mirror of the sky. The Falaknama Palace is 2000 feet tall. When was Golconda built? 1143 AD. The Golconda Fort was erected in the year 1143 under the Kakatiya dynasty. However, it rose to prominence when it came under the rule of Qutub Shahi dynasty during the 16th century, that is, when Quli Qutub Shah declared his independence from the Bahmani Sultanate in 1518. Who invented Golconda? Sultan Quli Qutub ul Mulk, 1487 to 1543 AD, sent as governor of Telangana, established it as the seat of his government around 1501. Bahmani rule gradually weakened during this period, and Sultan Quli formally became independent in 1538, establishing the Qutub Shahi dynasty based in Golconda. What is Golconda diamond topaz? The Golconda diamonds are Indian diamonds mined in a specific geographic area within the historic Golconda Sultanate, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh states of India. A member of the topaz family, white topaz is colorless and most affordable. Who was the last ruler of Hyderabad? Sir Mir Usman Ali Khan Siddiqui. His Exalted Highness Nawab Sir Mir Usman Ali Khan Siddiqui, Asaf Jah 7th GCSI GBE 6th April 1886 to 24th February 1967, was the last Nizam ruler of the princely state of Hyderabad, the largest princely state in British India. How did Nizam come to Hyderabad? The first Nizam ruled in place of the Mughal emperors. After Aurangzeb died, the Mughal empire collapsed, so the Nizams created an independent kingdom. When the British got power over India, the Nizams continued to rule Kingdom of Hyderabad after coming into an understanding with the British. Did you know the ancestry of the Nizams? Nizams originally belonged to the Turkic dynasty from around Samarkand in today's Uzbekistan. Khwaja Abid is believed to have visited the Mughal India in 1655 AD. Shortly after that, he is said to have presented himself before Emperor Shah Jahan. Impressed with his skill sets, the emperor granted him favors and a position in the imperial service. Who is the first Nizam? Mir Qamar ud-Din Siddiqui. The dynasty was founded by Mir Qamar ud-Din Siddiqui, a viceroy of the Deccan under the Mughal emperors from 1713 to 1721. Mughal Emperor Muhammad Shah then invited Qamaruddin to Delhi. The emperor then extended an olive leaf and gave the title of Asaf Jah on Qamaruddin. Asaf Jah means equal to Asaf. He intermittently ruled after Aurangzeb's death in 1707 and under the title Asaf Jah in 1724. Who is the seventh Nizam? Mir Usman Ali Khan Asaf Jah seventh, 1911 to 1948. On September 12th, 1911, the world famous Mir Usman Ali Khan Bahadur Asaf Jah seventh got coronated as Nizam seventh. He was born in 1886. During the World War I, he extended military, financial and material support to the British. He established the Usmani University in Hyderabad in 1917. Several public buildings in Hyderabad that are functional today were built by him. Why last Nizam refused to merge Hyderabad state with India? In 1947, India became an independent nation and asked all the princely states to merge with the Union of India. However, the last Nizam, Mir Usman Ali Khan, refused to merge Hyderabad state with India. He desired to retain Hyderabad as an independent sovereignty. However, India's first Home Minister, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, in no uncertain terms, told the Nizam that India will not tolerate this. Why and what for Operation Polo, launched in Hyderabad in 1948? With no hope of solving the Hyderabad problem until the June 1948, an annoyed Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel launched Operation Polo on September 13, 1948. The Nizam's army surrendered on September 7th. In November 1948, the last Nizam formally acceded to the Indian Union, thus bringing the Asaf Jahi dynasty's rule in Hyderabad to an end after 225 years' rule.